free. And Jay Gelley says you might maybe not see that, but a little more of the same today in terms of the weather that we're going to see.
Yeah, what that was most likely caused by is a strong, very strong downdraft. In the upper levels, you get cold air. It's dense. It comes rushing down toward the surface, and that generates the wind. And as you can see, it'll lift up a tree and push it across the neighborhood. For today, like you said, possibility of seeing maybe a little bit more of that, at least a couple of strong thunderstorms. Take a look at the radar imagery. We are seeing a few showers making their way through the area right now as we speak. We'll zoom in just a little bit, say right across near Thibodaux. You see this working through. This is going to continue moving across the area. And we've got one little spotty shower right there just to the west of Jean Lafitte. So these will probably continue slowly developing off and on through the morning. As we get into the latter part of the morning and get into the afternoon, a little daytime heating, scattered to numerous showers and storms once again. So let's be prepared. We'll have another round of that, but everything changes tomorrow. More on that in a few moments. 77 degrees in Slidell, 81 in Galliano, 84 in Grand Isle. So temperatures pretty much running where they have been for the most part. And as you can see, lots of rainfall moving through the Great Lakes. And then down here through our neck of the woods, that's because we are tracking a bit of a cold front. There's this big trough that's moving through. It is going to try to drag a cold front our way. Some of the models say, yeah, it's going to move through. Here's what I'm thinking. There's a front situated still across parts of Arkansas. It's going to move and then probably stop just below the state line between Louisiana and Mississippi, maybe right above Interstate 12. I think that's as close as it will get, but it will serve nonetheless as a focal point for more showers and thunderstorms later on this afternoon. This is what's left over Ernesto right now, a depression moving across Mexico, might even duck back in on the other side into the Pacific and get somewhat regenerated there. National Hurricane Center is tracking this, giving it a 50% chance of becoming a tropical system. This will probably become a depression, so we'll keep an eye out for that. And speaking of what used to be or what is a depression, this is Tropical Depression number 17. This, by the way, the remnants of Florence, not really worried about this. While it may redevelop slightly, it's not a problem. So we're going to focus right here on Tropical Depression number 7. We'll map it out for you. Watch over the next few days. What's going to happen is, looks like this will become Gordon at some point. As you can see, max sustained winds right now running at about 50 miles per hour. That would make it a tropical storm. And by the time we get to late Tuesday night into Wednesday, still only about 60 mile per hour winds just the west, southwest of Jamaica. Like I said, we'll keep an eye on it for today. Here's what we're looking at, another round of potentially strong thunderstorms right here. Terrebonne Parish, Lafourche Parish along the Mississippi Gulf Coast. Also by 4 o'clock, another push as that front gets a little bit closer. By 7 o'clock, some lingering showers. By 1 a.m., we'll start to dry out. This model really dries us out for the most part tomorrow. As you can see, by about 4 o'clock, maybe a couple of spotty showers to the south of the lake. I'm going to keep a few more showers in the mix for tomorrow. But for today, going to be rainy. 70% chance of rain, lightning, gusty winds, heavy downpours, localized street flooding, temperatures mid-80s to lower 90s. We'll dip into the 60s, maybe in a couple of spots tomorrow morning. Upper 60s, mid-70s, holding on to about a 20% chance of rain. And then notice what happens on Saturday. Again, 40%. Maybe I'll drop that to 30. We'll see what happens, but I'm leaving it at 40 right now. Sunday, completely dry. By the time we get to Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we'll keep about a 20 to 30% chance of rain. Again, through Monday, right through Thursday. So it's going to be wet today. And then by the time we get to Sunday, we'll start drying everything out. All right, there's your look at weather. Randy, back to you.